Welcome to Walton FM.
Good afternoon and hello and welcome to Walton FM. We've got some new people in the house today. Well, I say new. One of them's come back from beyond to join us again. But we're in a new year at Walton Hall, so we thought we'd have a new radio club. So who have we got in the house today?
Jamie, it's me from a few months ago.
The main one, Boogaloo, and...
I'm Bob.
A.K.A. Yep, Bob. Who else have we got over here?
Connor.
And we've got Connor, who's going to be producing it today. Right then. So, I think, without further ado, we should get on to, like, is it good to be back?
I mean, yeah, it's good to be back after 7 weeks of not being here,
six or seven.
And I'm happy that I'm back now because I can do all my lessons that I do because I start year 10 GCSEs next year.
Justin.
And that's a panic.
You can't be. You're not that old yet.
I'm sadly leaving Key Stage 3 next year, going up to Key Stage 4.
Really?
Yep.
Jamie, that means if you're getting older, then I'm getting ancient. That's not good. That's not good. Blah, that's amazing though, isn't it?
It is, isn't it?
And Bob, now you're new, aren't you? You're year 7?
Yeah.
Whose class are you in?
I'm Navigators 2 and I'm in Mrs. James' class.
Miss James' class. So how are you finding it so far?
Full name Katie James.
A.K.A. To be fair, before we start with how you find in Walton here, did you have a good summer?
Yes.
So what did you get up to?
I went to a PGL camp in Shrewsbury. We did archery tag. That hurt me.
What's archery tag?
Oh, no. So you've got a bow and arrow and you've got a big marshmallow on it, so if it hits you, it doesn't really hurt. We've got to wear a mask, so if it hits you without a mask...
If it does hit in the face, I can make sense. So did you get hit many times?
No.
Or were you the artful dodger?
I hit it at a 90-degree angle, 87-degree angle. I still hit some young...
Precision.
I went like that and just bang, right on their forehead.
No. But I suppose the headshot, does it count if it's a headshot?
No, it did count.
Oh, it does count. Oh, not like dodgeball or anything like that. So was that the best bit that you did? Was that the most fun you had this summer?
A bit. But I also went to Alton Towers and Drayton Manor with them.
No way. Have you been to Drayton Manor and Alton Towers, Jane?
No, I haven't been. But cool thing is, actually, I have a Merlin pass and it's the gold one.
Yeah.
I'm planning, I'm going to do Scarefest and I'm going to go in a few weeks to Alton Towers and I'm going to go to Thorpe Park again. Because I absolutely love it there.
I haven't been to Thorpe Park for years, man. It's meant
have
to be like
not?
It's meant to be up there now with Alton Towers, isn't it? Like,
I mean, there's a ride that looks like this.
yeah.
And I went on that, and it was so
but
cool.
But for the viewers, for the listeners, sorry, out there, Jamie just did a massive arc, as in it was so steep to go up and it's so steep to come back down. I bet that sort of thing would make, I think I'd have to change my pants.
And
a couple of
when
times.
It's too windy, you roll all the way back down. And guess who happened that to? I did that. And we got stuck for about 3 hours.
No.
On literally the ride? On the ride, yeah. Literally on the top, like this.
Nightmare.
On the top. They had to get a helicopter and everything to come and get us.
What? That I've just turned my stomach thinking about that. That's not good.
And the person almost died, so that was really sad.
Oh, no, that's not good.
Because they were panicking really badly. They were having, like... they were having a heart attack as well, but they, thank God, survived. Otherwise, that ride would have been closed down.
That wouldn't have been good. Mm-hmm. So now you're back at school then now. Oh, you for the first time there, Bob. Yeah.
And also
what?
Also reminded me of the time on Smiler like that. I didn't get stuck, but there was this, like, a really big bit that you just goes up.
I won't go
on the Smiler. And it'll just swirl you around, like, really fast.
And that's too scary.
And it petrified me, and I was just like, what the hell has just happened to me?
Well, I got the same thing with Oblivion. I can't go on Oblivion. I don't know what it is. When it first opened up many moons ago, I went on it, and it really scared me. So I thought, right, I'm going to keep going on it until I conquer my fear, because I say if you do it more... Then you get, what's the word? It becomes easier, yeah, because you know it, yeah, and you know what to expect. After the sixth time, I think I was more scared than I was the first time. I thought, no, that reverse psychology is not working on me. I can't stand it. I'm not sure about the smiler. I looked at it and thought, that looks just as scary as Oblivion. So I'm not.
The Oblivion drops right down.
I got stuck on that
as well.
You know the worst thing about Oblivion is it holds you at the top, doesn't it? Right?
Yeah.
So it goes over. But it's not the same every time. If it was like 2 seconds, you'd be like, yeah, well, I can do this because then I know to hold my breath. I know it's coming. Hold 2 seconds sometimes, like 3, 4, boom! He's like, what?
Yeah.
Other times you go, it's like 3 seconds.
I actually got stuck on that.
No.
I got stuck on the smile as
no.
well.
Oh, that's horrible.
So basically, we were just about to drop,
yes.
And it didn't drop.
Nope.
And then,
you mean just stayed up?
It just stayed. It just stayed there. And we started to go over a little bit,
that's
and just
worst.
Stopped by there.
Oh.
I was there for 6 hours.
That's
I was
not
tired.
Not
they had to call the fire brigade. The fire brigade were refusing to climb up the ride and come get us.
No.
So then they had to get a helicopter. Put like a so. They put like this massive trampoline at the bottom. It was a massive trampoline, and I was actually
frightened.
How big was
this trampoline, man?
I don't know. It's just a massive blow up trampoline thing.
Right. Okay.
And then they said, okay, we're gonna unbuckle you, and you're gonna drop onto the trampoline, and then we'll take you to safety.
Serious. Health and safety's gone out the window at that place since I used to go.
I did. So I was like, okay, I'll turn this into a bit of fun because I was bored. And I backflipped all the way down.
I'd love to have seen
Lucky.
That, Jamie. Lucky.
And then I did a Naruto pose and I landed on.
Right, so going back to school now, so we've had a lovely summer. So being new, what have you made of Walton Hall, Bob? What do you think about it?
I like it.
You do? What do you like about it then?
I like all my classes and all my teachers.
Now that's good news. Is there no one that you're a bit like, oh God, not him again? Like that bloke who does music. He's stupid.
You know,
he,
you're talking
he?
About
what?
Yourself, right?
What? What?
Yeah, you are talking
evil
about
twin,
yourself.
That is evil twin.
Oh,
no,
you know,
no,
like,
no.
He's come and he's in Navigators 2.
Yeah.
I'm in Navigators 3.
Right.
But then for 3 lessons in the morning, set from a Friday.
Yeah.
I'm with them.
Just blown my mind.
And
Jamie.
Then I'm with Navigators 3 in the afternoon. Yeah, I know. It's really
that's,
weird.
That's good. That's, I mean, I can't keep up with my timetable at the moment, let alone. So, what's been. Okay, we'll go both of you now. What's been your favourite lesson so far?
Music.
Really? God, that's amazing. Did you just say music, Bob?
Really no, awesome. You covered your mouth over and saying music. I'm not stupid.
Listeners, don't believe him. Don't believe him. No, go on. What's been your favourite lesson so far?
My favourite lesson is the one before home time.
what is that then?
Because I get to go home straight after.
I thought it was either going to be that or it was going to be because you do something really cool. Because we get to go home. That's fair enough. It's a good lesson. I like it. What's been your favourite lesson so far, Jamie?
My favourite lesson is coming up this afternoon.
So what's that one?
Farm.
Farm. Loads of people love the farm, working with the animals and doing that sort of thing.
Have you heard who the new farm teacher is this year?
No, tell me.
Mrs. Scaife.
Mrs. Scaife, really?
And Miss Connor and Miss Kelly.
Oh, very cool, very cool. Are you looking forward to it, miss?
Yes, I'm very excited to see the people.
Excellent. We used to have loads of peacocks. When I first started here, I think it was just after the dinosaurs were wiped out. there were four peacocks that used to go around, blue ones all over the place. But I suppose they were a bit old then and stuff like that. So, but now there's one. It's lovely, to be fair. Lovely. So what, we're coming to the end of our session, really, to be quite honest with you. So what are you looking forward to at Walton Hall this year? We'll start off with Jamie. What are you looking forward to most?
I'm looking forward to after Christmas, where I'm starting to pick my stuff to go to Key Stage 4.
Fantastic, fantastic.
I'm also very nervous about that. But,
it's a different challenge,
I've
isn't it?
I've got quite a lot to do this year as a Year 9. Yeah.
But you will and be amazing at it.
On top of that, next year I've got to do GCSEs.
The big one. That's very true. But you've got some great people to guide you along.
I've recently just moved into a new house with 2 kids that are currently going to college. And I was there on their results day for their GCSEs.
How did you go? Were they scared? Were they nervous?
They all passed.
Oh, that's fantastic news.
But that just scares me a little bit that I might not pass.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Never think like that, Jamie. Never think like that at all.
And I really want to go to college.
Yeah.
And I don't want to go to sixth form. Oh. So does that mean I leave after year 11?
It would do. It would be that would be your last.
Is it just year 10 GCSEs or year 11 or GCSEs as well?
Year 11 GCSEs. Well, it depends. They put you more, it'll be more year 11. But there are a few people who do some accreditations in year 10 as well. But the GCSEs are mainly year 11.
Yeah. And I've already decided what I'm doing.
Okay, go on.
This might shock you.
To the core.
I am not doing performing arts next year.
That has actually shocked me, to be honest with you. Serious?
Yeah, I am. I'm really serious.
Well, what are you doing instead then?
I'm doing childcare and motor vehicles.
That's lovely. So you can look after children while they're
driving. Because I want to be a teacher. I want to teach year ones and year twos.
That's lovely, Jamie.
And maybe work in a nursery. What's it called? Those days where you don't come to school and you go to like a nursery or something.
Work experience.
Yes.
Yeah. I was going to really say skydiving then.
Work experience. I really want to do work experience as well. Do you do work experience in year 10?
You know what, off the top of my head, I don't know. I know there has been in the past, but I do not know the PFA structure now. So
I hope so.
Preparation for adult life does start in year 10.
I could start working in a nursery and work my way up.
That'd be amazing.
Maybe being a TA or a teacher.
They've got,
being a one-to-one.
They're big on apprenticeships at the moment. Mm-hmm. And you can get a lot of TA apprenticeships where you work in a school and then study outside school. So maybe that'd be brilliant. Well, that's fantastic, Jamie. Go on, and what are you looking forward to most, Bob, this year at Walton Hall?
I'm looking forward to doing forest school.
Fantastic. It's amazing with Mr. Chase.
Yes, I think this afternoon I'm doing it with Mr. Chase, the one not too far from my house, classroom.
Classroom, yeah.
And it's just fun because when I did transition, we did a thing like dinosaur, but like red light, green light.
Yes, that's a great game.
But we did it with a duck whistle.
Oh, I've never really done that. He's got some wacky ideas, our Mr. Chase says. That's fantastic. Yeah. Right, well, we're going to have to wrap it up here, I'm afraid, because you've got to go back to class. But thank you very much, guys, for coming up today. You got to come up next week?
Yeah, we'll
see. See if we can get a few more people up as well.
I will continue being on the radio.
Fantastic.
Because I love talking to people. I love...
That's
I've always wanted to become a YouTuber, like vlogging and stuff. And like,
best way to start.
It's prepping me for when you guys are listening, but I don't see you. So it feels like I'm talking to a screen.
You don't see
But I am talking to other people in this case. But I do have a YouTube channel.
Go on in quickly before we wrap it up. Tell us about it.
It's called Jamie is the Best Drag Queen, and I post my drag queen photos on there.
Fantastic.
So if you want to have a look, go, you can.
Brilliant. Excellent. Well, thank you ever so much, guys. You're going to say goodbye to everybody?
Bye, I'm Bob.
Bye, everyone. Hope you have a nice week, and we will see you next week on Monday morning.
Definitely. Take
care,
guys.
Bye.
You are listening to Walton FM, the one and only best radio station in all of Walton.
I don't think so. No, 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 no. I don't think so. No, 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 no. It's never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. I don't think so. No, 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 no. It's never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. I don't think so. No, 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 no. Maybe someday you'll have it your way. Maybe someday it'll all work out. Probably never, ever, 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 ever gonna happen. Oh no.
underground shit that you did was scam. I got a room full of your posters and your pictures, man. I like the shit you did with rockets too, that shit was fat. Anyways, I hope you get this, man. Hit me back, just the chat. Truly yours, your biggest fan, this is Stan.
Try to understand that I do want you as a fan. I just don't want you to do some crazy I seen this one on the news a couple weeks ago that made me sick. Some dude was and drove his car over a bridge and had his girlfriend in the trunk, and she was pregnant with his kid. And in the car they found a tape, but they didn't say who it was to. Come to think about it, his name was, it was you.